All right, well, this is how we're leaving. Got her all packed up, moved the cooler inside. Dog still have pretty good room. Carrier's not too loaded down, so we'll see how it goes. I've had worse places to be broken down. Not really broken down, but we definitely have some sort of oil leak that is substantial. And relatively consistent. So I've been in low gear. And it looks like it could either be coming from the transfer case or the transmission. But it could also be the overdrive as we're running on it for quite a while today. And it's definitely oil. So, let's see how much oil we have left. Well, I don't think it's engine oil. I don't know what y'all can see, but it was a little over full, so maybe it was. I'd rather see how that would happen. Might have to assume it's either the transfer case fluid was a little darker than that, though. What seems to be coming out, so it makes me think it's either the overdrive, because I have no idea how much I was supposed to put in that, or maybe the transmission, but it doesn't. It feels more like gear oil, which is what is in the transmission, but now I need to figure out what is low. Maybe since we just got here, sit and just enjoy the view for a minute. No, we're good. Thank you, though.
Where'd he go?
So it's gotta be. Yeah, it's gotta be the overdrive. Must have put away too much oil on it. gotta turn air down the tire or something. Yeah.
You're up at 50 right now, which is way too hard for this stuff.
What did I get
in the moon, though? I need to air up at a gas station. I'm not going to drop them down much, just enough to see if it...
Make a change.
It'll make it the ride a lot smoother, too. Huh? Very interesting. I am recording it.
That didn't look good. It's not turning. Half the time there's no power to the front wheels, so like only one wheel spin and then the other wheel spin. Trouble getting some traction. Never very helpful with the mechanics. Yeah, what's wrong with it? Alright, why can't we go nowhere? Yeah, I didn't think so.
Weather is terrible today, but you can see that hole shouldn't be there. That shouldn't be there either. Oh boy. Alright, well, mount championship could have gone better. Looks like we fried the rear diff one way or another. I haven't broken it down yet. You'll see the short video I took of the holes that are poking out from the inside, it looks like. So I originally thought I may have rolled back onto a rock and cracked it, but it looks like I think the rear diff exploded, which isn't great. Also killed a GoPro. Pretty good. So trip could have gone better, but we did make it back. Wasn't really in the mood to film after all that. We ended up camping there a whole other night, so it didn't ruin the trip or anything. But I had to drive back on the front axle only. Checked to make sure the fluids were good about every 40 minutes on the way home. Topped off the rear diff every 40 minutes on the way home. We went through about 7 quarts of oil. Looks like the transfer case is fine. The overdrive was the problem. I think it's leaking pretty substantially. I put, I think, 3.5 quarts in it, and it started slipping on the way home as well. Luckily, the traffic was so bad, we never really went above 50 anyway, because we weren't able to. But we were able to make it home. So, Series 3, though she broke, I don't think there's any modern car today that would have made it back. And with a rear diff exploded. On the drive home, there's no bad noises as far as coming from the rear diff. That's why I kept driving it. That combined with the girlfriend was in the car, and I did not want to make a 12-hour tow day out of it. So I tried to figure it was probably better just to go for it and see what happened. Otherwise, trip was fun. Had a great time. Got some work to do on the Series 3 now, but we'll have to update you as that goes along.